Trying to get snapshots of your favorite live act can often result in blurry, noisy, and downright underexposed images due to the quickly changing and performance-driven lighting, not to mention the constantly moving subjects who are your choice of rock gods for that particular evening. What is up, guys and gals? Rap here from BNC Camera. Snag the dream gig of a lifetime snapping photos at a concert or event? Well, stick around, as in today's video we'll be going over some pointers that'll get you through your concert shoot. Now, many beginning photographers are drawn to concert photography because the subjects are both exciting and visually interesting, and a bit more pulse-pounding than a landscape. But then they end up discouraged because out of 1,000 shots, there are only 3 that don't have a light streak through the center of it. Unfortunately, since every event is different, there's no one checklist of camera presets carved in stone that will guarantee a perfect photo each time. But not to worry, because we're going to quickly go over some tips that will at least get you started off on the right steel-toed foot. Using your general knowledge of photography principles, let's zero in on some of the basics of setting up your camera for success in dark venues where you'll be immortalizing the next Las Vegas headliner. We need to adjust shutter speed, aperture, and ISO to expose correctly. During a live event, your biggest challenge is light. So when it comes to your exposure triangle, you'll have to compensate above all else: a slow shutter speed, a fast f-stop, and a higher ISO. If your shutter speed is too slow, your motion images will be blurry. If your aperture is too open and you're too physically close to your subject, the critical elements of your picture will be out of focus. And if you crank up your ISO too high, your overall picture will be grainy. So keep these things in mind. The first thing to do is pick what you're willing to sacrifice. 10 times out of 10, it's going to be the ISO that's going to be pushed far beyond its usable limits. You always want to prioritize the crispiness and sharpness of your photo. With today's technologies, post-editing can clean up a lot of in-camera ISO noise and grain. If done well, a certain level of grain can even give your images a filmic quality and texture, something not uncommon in even the greatest of live event pictures. Another tip, expose for the stage. Where your live acts are strutting their stuff is where the most light will be found. If you try to accommodate the light on the stage, you'll end up with more properly exposed images more often. But just remember, you'll be sacrificing details in the crowd and surrounding venue. If you can get very comfortable with your camera, you'll be able to toggle settings quickly, adjusting for wherever you decide to point your lens. All this means is you'll be shooting in manual mode, and no preset camera mode will be able to handle the shifts in light or action of a live event. Try to get your shutter speed up to 1/250th of a second, and try to open your aperture to at least 1.8. When it comes to white balance, you can relax a bit because this is one of the few elements of concert photography that allows you to cruise in auto mode. Click your camera into drive mode, continuous, and set your metering to spot metering. Once you're ready to rock and roll, just make sure you're shooting your images in RAW. While this usually takes up a lot more space on your memory card, you'll be absorbing all the data your camera is capable of. This is important, as post-editing is often pivotal in live event photography. You want as much to work with as possible when you're refining your images long after the lights have come up and the band's gone home. And the final tip is practice. No genre of photography is simple, but there's even more incentive to go out and sharpen your skills with concert photography because you get to do two things you love simultaneously. The more practice you get in, the more second nature it'll be for you when you're out on the sides of the stage or in the photo pits. To our fellow concert shooting photographers out there, let us know any other tips in the comments section. Also, be sure to like and subscribe as we'll be putting up more insightful videos for your production success. This is Raph from BNC Camera, living on a prayer, signing off.